I'm not saying that's the precise reason the bombing happened. That's one of the mundane reasons. That's one of the benefits they got. I don't think that was the precise reason. I think the deeper reason was that it did inaugurate this country into the age of terror. I mean, prior to 1995, terrorism or war was not a concern. You went about your day and you weren't concerned about being bombed. Oklahoma City started to plant that seed in people's minds.
Now you gotta have spies that grab your wife's breast and genitals because Al-Qaeda might be hiding in there.
Exactly, and the seed was planted, and when 9/11 happened, no one was surprised. It was going to happen one day because of Oklahoma City. Even prior to Oklahoma City in 1993, you have the World Trade Center bombing in New York City with an ammonium bomb and a Ryder truck and an FBI handler who was running the whole operation. That sounds kind of familiar. And that failed. They were supposed to park that truck next to the columns. They were too dumb to even do that. And they were really supposed to start get the ball rolling in 1993. And Oklahoma City itself was a sloppy job. When people say, you know, the government can never pull off something as perfect as that. People would talk. People are talking. People involved are talking. And it was a screw-up. There were bombs found inside the building that did not explode. The whole building was supposed to come down. They messed up on the cover-up left and right. They had to kill people because of that. I mean, they messed up left and right. It was a government operation. It was incompetent. But they can rely upon the mainstream media to not pursue those leads.
I mean, even to that end, the first hours after the event, you know, that's where you always get the most truthful information, where they're actually talking to people on the streets that saw what, you know, actually happened. Channel 4 was the only station that continued to investigate the truth in this case.
So the New York Times bought them out.
Exactly. Bought them out. The program director's contract isn't renewed.
She was fired. The programming director was fired. Janet Davis was let go. Her contract is not renewed. But, yeah.
Let's go to more calls. It's just incredible. The film covers it all. Available at InfoWars.com. A Noble Lie. A must see. Because this needs to be on every access station. Show it at your church. When your preacher gets up and says, worship government, say, well, okay, but what about the corrupt people in top of government? Jesus was speaking out against the bad government. Is that of the devil? Because, I mean, churches now, it's just worship, get ready to give your rights up. You know, God wants you to worship tyranny. I mean, it's all Homeland Security run. They're getting ready for some new big stage terror. They would have already staged more, but we're exposing them. Let's go ahead and take another call here. Kevin in Oregon, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey. Hey, how's it going, brother?
Good.
Hey, one of the things that was proof to me right off the bat is when they came out and said that I used to work for Ford, so the way that they somehow detected this Ford van was because of the tag on the differential, and I can tell you this as fact, that tag has nothing to do with any kind of ID numbers or anything like that.
Number.
It has strictly to do with gear ratios and things like that.
It's
the same
number,
kind
yeah.
of stupid small mistakes were made in 9/11, you get these reporters kind of reporting from every little location during the day of 9/11, and the lady actually points the camera down at all the trucks parked there and said, "Oh, look, the same people that did the terrific implosion in Las Vegas of the casino are here to take care of Building 7." Now I'm telling you this: it's not some.
Sir, I didn't hang up on you.
It's not some guy that drives up in with a minivan with a box of dynamite in the back of his van. You're talking about big...
Yeah, dynamite. Let me stop you, because I heard those types of things on the radio that day, because in between watching TV and being on all the different Genesis shows, you know, I drove to get a pizza a half mile away. I've told the story and heard CBS radio back when they still had that, announcing they're going to blow up Building 7, Solomon Brothers, for everyone's safety. And of course, we know Controlled Demolition Inc. that blew up the remains of Oklahoma City building. They were involved in all that. And I heard them blow it up. And then I got home and everybody's like, yeah, they said they blew it up. But then they said, that's a conspiracy theory. You never heard that. Since then, we found a lot of the newscasts where they did say they're going to bring it down. BBC screwed up and said it's already fallen and showed it. And of course, then they go, wait, it hasn't fallen. But they go, well, go with the script. So kind of like they were announcing that they'd found Lee Harvey Oswald before he'd even been arrested. That was already being put out in the daily newspapers. Back in the day, they had papers in big cities that, you know, came out every few hours. You know, extra exclusives that would come off the presses. And so they screw up. Yeah, they screw up in the scripting. But I have not seen that footage. Are you saying, did you see it that day? Or is it online? Because a lot of people call in and we go find these bombshells that no one's paid attention to. You're saying there's footage. Because we got cops saying, get back, they're going to blow up Building 7. And then they blow it up. But are you telling me that you've got footage of them saying, oh, there's the Controlled Demolition, Inc. They're here to help with Building 7, blow it up. Are you saying you have that clip?
CNN, that they shot this, and I wish I did have the clip. I've tried to find it, but I can't because they've buried that thing so deep.
No, I know. But there's actually dozens of them, so we already have them saying similar things. And then the debunkers get in my face on the streets, and they go, you're saying the cops blew it up. And I go, no, they told the cops, who I've interviewed, by the way, the officers, who are also on the news. We've actually had a chance to run into them and find them. They told them, okay, they're going to blow it up. It was on the news. They said, for its safety. They had a countdown. They blew up Building 7. Then they didn't want that investigated, so they said, never happened. And you're supposed to just say, okay, never happened, because it's amazing the level of mind control. Holland?
Yes, the caller is right about the Ryder truck and the number on that. And that was bandied about by the media as the FBI was so good that they tracked down this vehicle identification number on the axle and have identified this Ryder truck tied to this rental agency in Kansas. But
that's like passports falling out of the sky that survive on 9/11 and are found that day.
We went and talked to Ford about this, the representative, and he chuckled. He looked at us. He said, that's a part number. That's nothing to do with identifying the truck. You cannot track the truck through a part number. And so, I mean, the first clue that they use to justify their whole arrest and tracking down a McVeigh is false. It's utterly false from the horse's mouth.
So it's just like the magic passports of 9/11.
Exactly.
And, you know, you talk about them talking about bringing the building down in 9/11. We've got probably 3 to 4 minutes, 20-plus people saying, second bomb. We've got we see the bomb squad down at the Oklahoma City, at the Murrah building. We see people in the military saying that the second bomb that was disarmed the night before was even bigger.
The Air Force was stating that even the day after the bombing, their representative was stating
that. You
have
the governor saying they found more bombs.
Yeah, and now we're supposed to just act like that didn't exist, shut up, conspiracy theorists, right?
No, and it's on all the channels. BBC simultaneously on two channels says it's fallen on its own footprint, as it later did perfectly from small fires. And then on 9/11, they've got all these guys that are definitely operatives, baseball caps on, coming on the news within minutes of the towers falling and giving the official story of jet fuel pancaking caused the steel to melt and weaken, and so it fell into its own footprint. Cut to the next channel. Another guy, just scripting. Boom, you've got the terrorist right there.
It is a script. Like with Oklahoma City, the day of the bombing, that afternoon, the ATF is announcing that it was a car bomb with 1,200 pounds of explosives. It's like, where did you come up with that number, man? I mean, how would you even hazard a guess as to how many pounds the bomb weighed? You don't even know what it is. Turns out later that the ATF was keeping 1,200 pounds, according to a rescue worker. He actually told the rescue worker that they were keeping 1,200 pounds of C4 in their illegal armory in the Murrah building. They were hoping it would blow up. It didn't, because the other bombs didn't go off, so they had to pull it out. But they actually got the number for the script, 1,200 pounds, from the amount of C4 they were keeping in their own armory illegally.
Well, they were keeping the stuff there that they used the extra to blow it up.
Yeah. Which and they is, say that it doesn't exist, and we've got footage in the documentary, A Noble Lie, showing them actually removing the C4 and weapons.
And you got Jane Graham sees these guys in there, whistling, putting the gray sticks of butter with the wires. Yeah. These people make me sick. Let's take more calls on the other side. I hope that answers your question, Kevin. Great points you brought up. Patriot, you're up next. And others, Sarah, John, Mark, stay with us. We'll be back. Got Bill Gates news coming up. A little over a year. By the way, John Bowne, one of our reporters, who also runs the show in there part of the time, the radio show /TV. We'll just talk to you during the next segment when our guests are gone. I said, man, you look bummed out. And he said, yeah, he lives in a whole other part of Austin, pretty far away from here. And he said, a silver Fed car with super dark windows with antennas all over it followed him all the way from his house to our office today and then drove off. And I was like, well, why don't you have a camera? And he usually does. And, with me, I would just immediately pull over. I mean, up at Bilderberg, they'd follow us and I'd start following them and they'd start running. And then we'd have these Marines in plain clothes flipping us off. Anybody that serves this system and gets off on this, trying to intimidate people around here, you do not intimidate us. You only validate everything we're doing and make us get up with a bigger spring in our step in the morning. It's so ridiculous and cowardly. Just do what you're going to do. Come on. Join pure evil. Sign on with the devil. strike me down, do whatever. I'll never be cowards like you. I'll never be attracted to evil. This big report, comic book hero, crafting the image of genocidalist Bill Gates as a lifesaver. That's an article up at Infowars.com. You know, his wife came out in Germany and said, those of you saying that we're trying to reduce population, you're going to cause the loss of life. That's like a double threat. Like, we don't know we're in danger. Like, we don't know. Look, get it through your head. We know. People that get jobs here are told up front, you're signing on to something real that can get you killed or set up or whatever. So that takes their fun away, though. See, we're not cowards like you who go and join the dark side thinking it'll give you all this power. We're not idiots like you. We're not trash like you. We're not cowards like you. So understand, we know you're murderers. We know you're shipping drugs in and little kids out. We know, okay? We know. You're like, hey, we're evil. Hey, better watch talking about. Oh, no, we know. We know. We know. Don't you understand? We know. We know. We know you'll blow up daycare centers. We know. We know. You understand? We know what's going to happen. We know. You understand? We know. You just can't get it to your head. We're not cowards like you. We know. We know. Going back to our guest, do you guys ever get threats? What type of stuff's happened to you making this film?
Well, I mean, nothing majorly overt. I think no one thought we'd get the movie done, so we weren't seen as a threat. There have been attempts in the past to infiltrate our efforts, and they've been foiled rather easily. But the making of the movie itself, I mean, doing that, I mean, we weren't dealing with overt threats, but I mean, there was a couple times we risked our lives, just interviewing some of these neo-Nazi suspects going out to the desert to Utah or the wilds of eastern Oklahoma. You don't know who you're going to run into, and some of these guys were involved with the bombing, even if they were federal informants or not, and they definitely have something to hide. So, I mean, but we felt compelled to do what we could to get the story out there. And we're from Oklahoma, we're Okies, and we filmed in Oklahoma, shot in Oklahoma, and we knew the story had to be told. Many of these people, survivors, victims, family members, had become friends of ours. And their story needed to be told because it's being ignored by the mainstream media. Like our director of photography, Devin Winter, he had interviewed some of our subjects already 3 or 4 times for History Channel, for Nat Geo, for other mainstream video channels or TV channels. And they told the same story each time. But with us, we didn't take everything that went contrary to the official story and leave it on the cutting room floor. We actually... That was the purpose of the interview, to show what was contrary to the official story. And they have never changed their story. The feds changed their story left and right. There's not even one official story for the Oklahoma City bombing. There's like 9 or 6 different plausible
excuses. And I want to be clear, these aren't even feds. These are criminals that have taken the federal government over.
Yeah, I mean, we've reached a period of history, I think, that it's called the criminalization of the state, where criminals basically have achieved positions of power, and they point the guns of the state at their enemies, at their political enemies, and they call them criminals. We have reached that stage, and we have to deal with as much as we can. We have to realize that, not have false hope, deal with the system when we can.
Hey, but you're a Marine. Doesn't it feel good to actually be fighting for America now against the real enemy? I mean, this is a real war.
Yeah, I mean... I joined the Marine Corps out of an instinct to protect my family and my land, and for a craving for a rite of passage and to seek adventure. Just I had a lot of testosterone. I didn't want a job, so I joined the Marine Corps. Plus, it was a family tradition, and I quickly saw that there were things in there I didn't like. I mean, when I took the oath in the beginning at the MEP station to defend.